Get it up.
What makes you get it up?
It wasn't strong enough, you had to get it up.
Here, do you want worse one? Hey.
Is proceed with the guidelines or the guidelines, guidelines that we have set up for the next committee to look at. You know, that should be something that is done at the end of the session, not.
Public meeting, not a budget meeting.
Correct.
That's why I didn't sit there.
It's a deliberative session.
That was the reason.
Okay, let me just, because maybe I am unclear. I thought that it was the budget, part of some of the budget committee who determined we had to have a table over there at one point. We've never done that in all the years that I've been on this committee, except maybe it was the past three.
So about 2 or 3 years ago, the Municipal Association published an article in the monthly magazine about how to conduct good public hearings and good town meetings, deliberative sessions, and the like. And their recommendation was always to have a governing body, if it's a deliberative session or a town meeting, the governing body front and center, and the budget committee, if you have an official budget committee, which apparently we do, off to the side or some up or up front offset, because they are also responsible for a part of the presentation that the legislative body is going to be talking about. And so it's a way to show who your public officials are. Your governing body, whether it's the school board or the select board, and then the budget committee, who's been, you know, who has approved or presented or whatever, the budgets.
Okay.
For both
entities.
Just a follow-up. Another best practice comment that I was reading on the Municipal Association or anything to consider is having, for town meeting, having a section for non-residents. A seating section for non-residents.
Well, you know, the fact that the Municipal Association may suggest a protocol doesn't mean we have to do it. They're just suggesting a protocol.
So
the part about having seats over here for the budget committee. I mean, it's perfectly, it's not unreasonable to say the budget committee members just start to sit in the front row. We can do that. We don't have to do that. And if we want to sit in the audience, we can.
And again, that could be something next year, you know, we should be at the beginning of the session, iron all this out as to how we want to move forward. I'm not going to remember, but also on the other two guys to. Yeah, there's two comments about the seating separately. We have done that occasionally on the school deliberative session, but then it was determined that the easiest thing to do was that every resident would have a card so there'd be no problem with voting or whatnot. So that was how that was handled. That was determined by the moderator and other folks who were in charge at that time. It was about 3 years ago we started using the cards. Someone who oversees the whole state and sees ideas that might work well everywhere. Maybe they don't work well here. Maybe our elected officials don't want to be recognized. And I don't know. I guess we'll figure that out in April.
So point of information. At a public hearing, I don't believe you need to be registered to vote. But those, whatever it is, to be part of the public and to make a comment, you do at a town meeting or a deliberative session.
Okay,
public hearing. I'm not sure if that's true. I mean, it's quite a
bit of information. Oh, you definitely do have to be a registered voter. You can get permission from the governing body or budget committee to permit the audience to speak, but not the council.
That's sorry, I
want
to
let
you. Well, I mean, I know that's definitely true for the deliberative town meeting where votes are taken. I know that is definitely. I do not know about public hearings. I do not know.
Okay, so I think Bert is right that you do have to be a resident, and the reason why is that we've always asked permission to allow the SAU staff to speak on behalf of the school board when they needed their assistance, and we had to ask permission of the governing body to allow that.
Yes, but that's a deliberative session, not a public hearing.
It wouldn't be any of the meetings. If they spoke, they should have been recognized. You know, it's always been the